Do you need to share Google Drive files and folders with specific people? Maybe you're wondering what type of sharing permissions you can set on Google Drive. Wonder no more. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to become a master sharer of Google Drive files and folders. Hey friends, I'm Tasia and welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. Today, I'm showing you how to share Google Drive files and folders and how to set important sharing permissions in Google Drive. Sharing Google Drive files and folders is a cinch. So let's first start with how to share a folder in Google Drive and make sure you stick around for important sharing permissions too. So here we are in my Google Drive, and I've got a few folders here. Now, to give you an example of how I use Google Drive, let's say a company reaches out to do a collab with me on my YouTube channel, I might want to share my media kit with them. It's not necessarily something I want to keep on my website, but it's definitely something that I'd like to easily share maybe with a link. So you don't even have to open up this entire folder if you don't want to. You can just simply right click on the folder here to open your sharing options. Now, you can select share, and this will allow you to manually add individual users or email addresses to grant access to this folder. But you may not want to be constantly manually adding people to a folder in order to grant them access. Maybe you just want to create a link and then be able to share that link at your convenience. Well, you can do that too. So the same thing here, right click on the folder, and this time select Get Link. From this pop-up, all you have to do is select Copy Link, and your link to this folder is now copied, and you can share it with whomever, whenever. And let's just say you have already actually opened up this folder and you're inside of the folder, you can share from here too by just clicking on the drop-down arrow to the right of the folder name and then selecting your sharing options. There's a big reason why sharing a link to a Google Drive folder is so powerful, but you'll have to keep watching to find out why. Now, let's say you just want to share a single file with someone and not an entire folder. Well, the exact same sharing options are available to you. So from your opened file, click on File and then Share. In this pop-up, you have the option to add individual email addresses or to create a shareable link. And of course, just like we showed before, if you're not in the file, you can just right-click on the preview of it and select either share or get link. Now these sharing options are great and all, but you're really gonna have to understand the sharing permissions when you want to share files and folders in Google Drive. So let's go over those important sharing options now. So the same sharing permissions are available whether you're sharing a file or a folder. So it doesn't matter whether you're manually adding email addresses or sharing a link. So if you're adding individual people to your file or folder, you'll notice to the right, there's this little drop-down arrow. Now you may not want someone to have full editor controls, for example, so you might want to set the share to viewer, where they can just view the document, or you can set that person to commenter. And then this way they can view the file or folder and leave comments on anything if necessary. And the exact same sharing permissions are available when you're sharing a link. So, right now my link settings are set to restricted. You're gonna wanna change this if you wanna be able to just easily share a link with anyone. So use the toggle here and make sure it's set to anyone with a link can view. Now you'll notice just like before, we have the same toggles to the right of this now where we can set the link permissions. If you're sharing a link, you probably should just keep it at the viewer permission level. That way, if you share the link with one person and that person wants to share the link with, say, their colleague, they can just pass along that link and it'll provide the person the same permissions. The permissions in this case are tied to the link itself rather than the individual person. So using a shared link as an example, here's what it looks like on the receiver's end. I've been working in Chrome, so let's go ahead and open up Firefox here. And I'm just gonna paste the link in the browser bar. And voila, Here is the folder I shared, and just as the permissions would suggest, I can view any of these files and the documents inside the folders, but I can't edit anything. If you're new to sharing and collaborating with people in Google Drive, you'll definitely want to check out the other videos that I've linked to in the description below, where I show you all the cool features of collaborating within Google Drive, like viewing and tending to comments, and also seeing a complete version history of your file. And if you're liking this video, go ahead and give it a like. It really does help to tell YouTube that this is the content you're looking for and you found it valuable. Now, remember when I told you there's a big plus to sharing a YouTube link to a folder? Well, here's why. Once you've created the link, you're done. That link will always stay the same regardless of what you add or remove from that folder. So you can always make sure your media kit or whatever it is that you're sharing is always up to date by adding new files and docs as necessary, and rest assured that whoever has access to this folder via this link is always going to be viewing the most recent version. Now keep in mind, you don't always have to share these giant, long, ugly URLs. You could use something like a link shortening service, and Bitly is a free one that I use in order to shorten the shareable link. Or you could add it as a hyperlink text in your email to the client or person you're sharing it with. Want even more Google Drive content? Yeah, you do. Be sure to check out the links below and again at the end of this video for even more Google Drive content. Well, that's how to share Google Drive files and folders and how to set sharing permissions in Google Drive. And now I want to hear from you. What do you love about Google Drive sharing permissions and the ability to share files and folders? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and oh gosh, look, here. And here and here for even more Google Drive content. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time.